Before leaving office, former President Trump pardoned several people with ties to Tennessee, including one mid-state man who has turned his life around helping troubled teens. News Channel 5's Jason Lamb has the story of Robert Sherrill and the woman he says always supported him.
This is where I lived. I lived back there. And she lived up front.
On a day when so many
lived here for a long time
are celebrating Robert Sherrill's presidential pardon, Robert is celebrating his late grandmother, Hattie Fletcher.
So this is my grandmother's house. Man, this house been in the family for so many years, and this is where it all begun.
It was here in North Nashville where Robert and his family came after being put out of the Dodge City projects.
We all played on this swing set, and it's been several different colors. It's been red, it's been blue, it's been white, it's been green.
But like the paint on what's left of his childhood swing set, Robert's story has several layers. As a teen, Robert dropped out of school, joined a gang, and eventually started selling drugs.
Off to federal prison I went.
After his release, Robert would return back here.
It's home to me, even though it doesn't look like it. It's home.
He started a cleaning business and a program to keep at-risk kids from going down the path he did.
I always want to motivate.
But today's pardon from President Trump may pale in comparison in Robert's eyes.
When she see me, she light up. She said, come on in here, boy.
To what Hattie might say today.
I knew you could do it. I knew you would be somebody. She said, I never doubted you. I'd never give up on you. That's what she always tell me.
A grandmother's support from beyond that Robert says helped fuel redemption here on Earth.
I just know she's looking down and she's proud. I know she is. And that's the first person I'm going to go see when I get to heaven.
Jason Lamb.
I got to go talk to her and see what she got to say.
News Channel 5.